friends, we're in the seven woes. And this morning we continue with 27, says, woe to you teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites. Remember, we've heard the word woe and hypocrite in every time Jesus speaks out against them. You are like whitewashed tombs. You look beautiful on the outside, but on the inside you are full of dead men's bones. And so Jesus uses a similar illustration like the cup. On the outside clean, on the inside dirty, Jesus says, just like whitewashed tombs. Now during the festivals, the roads would be improved as the people came up to Jerusalem. Not only would the roads be improved, but the tombs were painted with white paint. And this was done not only to beautify the tombs, but to make sure that no one would touch the tombs. Because if you touch the tombs, you were ceremonially unclean. And so Jesus speaks and he says to the Pharisees, on the outside you look whitewashed, you look wonderful, but what's inside of you is dead men's bones. In the same way, on the outside you appear to people as righteous, but the inside you are full of hypocrisy and wickedness. So Jesus says, people think you're so wonderful, you're so holy in your white clothes as if, but he says to them, to his disciples, don't be fooled by their outward appearance. Don't touch them. Just like you wouldn't touch a tomb, don't touch them. They are defiled. Jesus says they're hypocrites, they're actors, they're playing a role. Don't let them fool you to believe their words, he says, because they are wicked and evil. They are not righteous. Woe to you, teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites. You build tombs for the prophets and decorate the graves of the righteous. And so Jesus says, because some of the tombs were destroyed, he says, you rebuild these tombs for the prophets of old. You beautify their tombs. You beautify the tombs of people that were righteous. And you say, if we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have been part of them in shedding the blood of the prophets. So the Pharisees and the religious leaders said, if we lived in the days, in those days, we would never have allowed our people to do what they did to the prophets. We would never allow them to kill them. We would have honored them. We would have obeyed them. We would have respected them. We would have followed their teachings. We would have given heed to their warnings. And so that's why they did what they did. And so Jesus turns around and says, so you testify against yourselves that you are the descendants of those who murdered the prophets. Go ahead then and complete what your ancestors started. And so friends, Jesus doesn't hold back for one second. He speaks the absolute truth. And maybe you're shocked at just how harsh Jesus comes over. Because we sometimes think of Jesus meek and mild. But he speaks what he speaks, even though it's difficult, it's harsh words, even though he's judging them truthfully. And in many ways, this is love, because Jesus warns them that they're on their way to hell. And but if they change their ways, they can find salvation. And so that's what true love is, friends. True love is telling people the truth, but doing it in love. And so Jesus says, I know you're not going to repent. I know that what you've done, what your forefathers did by killing the prophets, you are going to do the same. You're going to kill my disciples. You're even going to kill me. And so this morning, my challenge to you, friends, is have you warned those you love? Because this morning, I want to ask you, who are those you love? Obviously, you love your family. They are friends you love. If you truly love them, hear me this morning, not just by feelings, but if you truly love those around you, then you are going to warn them. And because that's true love. Please, friends, take the opportunity to warn those around you that God loves them, but if they don't change their ways, they will also hear one day, woe to you. This is Rev Trev. God bless you.